Sebastian County, Arkansas, with a rash of small, flat, red spots and fever. The woman was from Mexico and had lived in Arkansas for 1 year before the onset of her illness. She later delivered a stillborn infant, with the pathologic findings compatible with intrauterine viral infection. Her exposure to the virus was from the household contact with a Mexican male, aged 20 years. Both patients worked in a processing plant in Fort Smith. The rubella virus was identified through the laboratory testing for a rising titer of antibodies to the virus using a latex bead angulation test. The virus is a positive sense RNA virus with an enveloped polyhedral capsid. Outbreak investigators interviewed household and workplace contacts of the woman, and an additional 10 cases were confirmed by laboratory testing. Among the 12 confirmed case patients, the median age was 23 years, 10 were Hispanic, 9 were born outside the United States, and 6 were women. All 6 female patients were pregnant, and 1 became infected during the first trimester of pregnancy. The pregnant patients exposed 155 women in the clinic waiting room as they were obtaining prenatal care. Out of 155 women, only 46 reported a complete history of childhood vaccination. Guys, I remember that rubella outbreak is like, rubella while you're pregnant is super dangerous. That's it for that one. It can cause all types of like fetal deformities and oftentimes stillborn babies to be, you know, stillborn as they're delivered. So really, really sad. It's really important to get your vaccines. And so some questions describe the clinical features of rubella. This is what rubella looks like. Maybe I can show you.
Thank you.
and the ice barrels. Gross. Testing of ice from the ice machines used to fill the barrels of the fecal contamination was negative. Culture analysis of the feces samples from the patient's grew pathogenic E. coli. Identification was completed by testing antigens on the cell wall and flagella. ELISA tests for Shiga toxins were positive. So let's see, gram stain looks, did I say it was positive or negative? Because it's red. I don't remember. I just read it, I think. Anyway, a positive gram stain. I'm pretty sure a positive gram stain is a purple. So it must be negative because it's pink. Some similarities, I think, in presentation. Except for the mouth. I told you the mouth thing. Let me see. Maybe in the front of the book. I should mention this book is by Rodney P. Anderson. And also, it was published in 2006. So it's kind of old. She was a cook, and I guess back then, whatever the year was, it was a long time ago. She, I guess they didn't really know about hand hygiene that well, so she like didn't really wash her hands. She got the people she served the food sick, and the thing people died from typhoid fever. And then they eventually linked it back to her. They said that she can't like be a cook anymore because she's a carrier, so she has the bacteria, but she didn't have the symptoms, and she could just pass it on. Listen, and she became a cook again, and people got sick, people died again because of her cooks, or because of her food. She was contaminating the food, and I think eventually she like got put to jail or something. I gotta read up on the story, but that's like the summary. Typhoid Mary. So unsafe sewage management has greatly reduced the risk in the United States. For more than 20 years, the annual U.S. incidence has been less than one case per 100,000 population, and almost all of the 400 or so cases seen each year have been in people who travel to areas where the disease is endemic, like it's common in that location. And like when a disease is common in a certain area. In 2002, in an outbreak in Florida, at least 16 people were infected over a relatively short time. These patients were not acquainted with one another, lived in several different counties, and received drinking water from at least four different water systems, shared no common recreational or social activities, did not use the same grocery stores or restaurants, and with one exception, had not recently been out of the country. Laboratory tests identified Salmonella enterica. I don't know if I said that right. Serovar typhi in all cases, and deoxyribonucleic acid, aka DNA, analysis confirmed all pathogenic isolates to be identical with each other. Three patients mentioned that they had consumed fruit shakes made with a tropical fruit called mamey. This fruit, also called sapote, is commonly used in fruit shakes called batidos, where it is mixed with milk, ice, and sometimes sugar. When 11 other patients were asked open-ended question about fruit and beverage use in a matched case control analysis, 10 said they had drunk mamey batidos. Food testing and trace backs to manufacturers show that mamey shake consumed by the patients were made with commercially packaged frozen fruit from two manufacturing plants in Guatemala and one in Honduras. None of the samples obtained from 49 supermarkets and 12 distributors showed Salmonella enterica cervar typhi, but all contained fecal coliforms of Escherichia coli. E. coli, basically. Okay, so I'm confused. Is typhoid fever from E. coli? I'm not sure. Ooh. Anyway, I guess that'll be it for this video. Let me know what you think. I can also talk, like, they have the case studies. I just mentioned the different case studies. But there's also pages, sections of where it just talks about a disease, and like, for example, this one is about tuberculosis, so case of the disease, how it's transmitted, pathogenesis, clinical features, diagnosis, treatment, stuff like that, prevention. If you are interested in knowing about, learning about that, a tuberculosis outbreak in a prison housing inmates infected with HIV, that could be for the next video. Interesting. Yeah, prisons. And disease is very, you know, very common because they're clustered together, right? Especially now with the coronavirus. Anyway, I hope you guys have an okay day. I hope you have a good day. I hope my day is at least an okay day. I have work tomorrow and I'm not looking forward to it because it's just, I enjoy my job. I got a new job. It's just, tomorrow is going to already be stressful because I know there's like a lot to do, so I'm just already stressing about it anyway. Have a great day, everyone. Learn a lot and good luck with whatever you're doing. If you're in school taking summer classes, good luck with that. And to the person who asked to do another microbiology video, I hope that you enjoyed this video.